This is the 100th anniversary of the Chicago Auto Show. And I do have to tell you, they do put on a very good show. This fountain is right in the middle of McCormick Place. It's very nice, almost hypnotic. And of course, McCormick is one of the best convention facilities in the country. It's got several levels, it's well laid out, and this huge courtyard is kind of in the middle of everything. Now, if you stand at floor level on that courtyard, you look to your right, you see one very large hall. Then you slowly look over to your left, and what have you got? Another hall. They use both of these halls for the auto show, and they have a lot of other space that they don't even use for the show.
Now, they certainly have a lot more space here at the Chicago Auto Show than they do in Detroit, but they don't get nearly the media attention that the Detroit show gets.
Obviously, you had a lot of people gathered for the unveil of the new Dodge Challenger. A lot of cameras, too, but you know, you'd have at least twice as many in Detroit. And also in Detroit, you wouldn't have a sheet pulled off of a vehicle. You'd have a more elaborate unveil. But however they unveiled it, let's face it, the Dodge Challenger is beautiful. This is the SRT8 version. It's also extremely powerful, 425 horsepower and a limited edition model. Chrysler CEO Bob Nardelli says this is something that's special for the whole company.
Couldn't come at a better time, certainly in our business cycle, to have something with such iconic brand and such brand loyalty, you know, kind of the legacy of the company. So, you know, I'm really excited.
Now, of course, all of that space that they have at the Chicago Auto Show allows them to do all sorts of interesting things, like this test track they've had for the Chrysler Group for several years. Some years it's Jeeps. This year it was a number of Dodge Ram pickups. And during the public show, they actually let people drive in these vehicles. They don't let the people drive them. They let the people ride in the vehicles around the track. Shows all the various attributes. Now, if you take a look at this picture, it's kind of hard to see on the small screen, but you can see a lot more space between vehicles than you would see, say, at the Detroit show. And also, there are exhibitors here that weren't in Detroit. You remember Porsche pulled out of Detroit. Not only have they got their vehicles, but they had an unveil there, a special high-powered version of the Porsche Cayenne SUV. Chicago is one of the biggest markets in the country for the Cayenne. Now, you've got some interesting things. I have no idea what this was. It's kind of a customized Ford F-650. This is really cool. This is a GMC Yukon Denali that was adapted to kind of look like the old Chevy Camino. This is just a concept car right now. But you know what? I actually think this might have some possibilities if they decided to put it in production. Now, this is the Ford Transit Connect. This is a European vehicle that Ford is going to bring to the U.S. In about a year or so. They showed how it can be adapted, like for a wine merchant. Also showed how it could be adapted for other uses. A jazz musician was called upon to customize this one. You can even see the saxophones in the back. This is the new Volkswagen Rattan. This is the Volkswagen minivan that's going to be made at the Windsor Assembly Plant. Look inside. Looks an awful lot like a Chrysler Town & Country. Yep, it's based on that. But it doesn't have the stow-and-go down there, and it doesn't have the swivel-and-go. Those are going to be exclusively Chrysler products. This is the Chevy Traverse. It's Chevy's version of the crossover vehicles that have been very popular for General Motors. Sister vehicles, the Saturn Outlook, the GMC Acadia, and the Buick Enclave. Of course, the Chicago Auto Show, a big consumer show during the public days. They usually get about 1 million people. I'm Auto Beat reporter Jeff Gilbert.